polling showing President Joe Biden defeating former President Donald Trump in a hypothetical rematch of the 2020 election. In a new survey from data company WPA Intelligence, 49% of likely voters say if asked to choose between Biden and Trump in the upcoming 2024 election, they would vote for Biden. 41%, meanwhile, say they would support Trump. But when Biden is put up against another likely 2024 Republican contender, Florida Governor Ron DeSantis, the latter comes out on top. In that poll, 45% say they would back DeSantis, while 42% say they would vote for Biden. So far, Trump is the only one of the three to officially announce for a 2024 run. Those sources say Biden is expected to announce in the coming months. Interesting that beats Trump, but DeSantis is sort of the different.
Yeah.
Different game.
In a different category. And John Heilman, I mean, there a lot of these random polls have been taken showing that Biden usually edges out Donald Trump. But you talk to Democrats, rank and file Democrats, you talk to contributors, you talk to the party members. They're a lot more concerned about a Ron DeSantis than a Donald Trump. They think that Joe Biden can beat Donald Trump. They've got the playbook. They know where Trump is weak. They know, yeah, but you just, let's talk about, I always talk about the Atlanta suburbs, not just the northern suburbs, but the southern suburbs of Atlanta. Those are areas Donald Trump will never get back. Mm-hmm. Those are also areas that Ron DeSantis could roll up some pretty good numbers with there. And this is not even a close call. Republicans have to know this, which makes you wonder why in the world they'd ever even consider putting up a nominee that was sure to lose the suburbs.
Well, right. I mean, I don't think you even have to get to the question of what Ron DeSantis can or can't do. I don't think you have to get to the question of what any of the other Republican potential nominees can or can't do. We just have no idea what Ron DeSantis is going to perform like on the national stage. We have no idea what any of these people are going to perform like as presidential candidates. Here's the one thing that we as the most known quantity in American politics is Donald Trump. We know everything we need to know about Donald Trump and his political strengths and weaknesses. We know, I'm not even talking about the personality, the threat to democracy, or the pathological lying. I'm just saying we now know where Trump can perform and where he can't perform, what he can and can't do, what his ceiling and floor are as a presidential candidate. And Joe, this is the thing. There's no Republican who's paid attention to his run in 16, his run in 20, and the Republican performance in the midterms around those years that doesn't know what baggage Donald Trump has and what the baggage is, as you just said, that he can't shed. There are voters he'll never get. There are places he'll never be competitive. And there are so many of them now that there's no world in which Donald Trump could, no imaginable world in which Donald Trump could ever win a popular majority in America, in the American electorate. And the window, the narrow needle that he needs to thread in the Electoral College has gotten narrower and narrower to the point where Trump is, he is a powerhouse within the Republican Party still. And yet on the national level, running, head-to-head presidential contest, a general election, he's getting close to, not unelectable yet, but he's the deficits he carries into that race are so huge and so well known and specified that if the Republican Party were a rational body with a single mind, there's no world in which he would be the nominee. But that, of course, is not the way our politics work. And there are still tens of millions of people in the Republican Party who don't see this and would vote for Donald Trump to be the nominee and vote for him to be president again. And that's the conundrum that the party faces.
Heilman's certainly right that there's a lot of unknown about Ron DeSantis, and there are certainly Republicans who think that a national vetting of DeSantis may not go that well. The more voters get to know him, the less they would like him. And the more Republicans that jump in, the rumors that Nikki Haley might be the first to take the plunge in a few weeks, the more Republicans jump in and make the field bigger, that's probably better for Donald Trump, who has, without question, a firm floor and ceiling in terms of his support. And that's what's complicated here. In terms of the White House's perspective, people around Biden think that Donald Trump will probably be the Republican nominee. That's the race they're preparing for. That's the race they like. Polls like this reinforced that. They feel like they'll win that one again, Willie. They like their chances in a rematch. It gets a little harder to predict if it's somebody else, but they think Trump is still the guy. They're preparing as such, and we should all expect President Biden to announce his reelection bid, likely within the next couple of months. There's some real talk about maybe even next month, February, around the State of the Union. Unclear, though, if this matter about the classified documents might delay that timetable.
Yeah, and as you know, the White House says, we beat him once, we're happy to beat him again, and they believe he's even weakened since they ran against him last time. That's looking into the future. This is the here and now for the White House, a push.